Okay, so I shorted DAL. I was letting the market open up here. I didn't grab it here. I was a little bit weary about this. It was going to pop back up and take off. Wasn't really, it was actually a gap up when it started. So anyway, got convinced in here, took the second ledge down, boom, boom, boom. Profit, profit, profit. That's 50 cents. I got a total of right at 50 cents. So good trade. Then kind of surprised by this. It dropped all the way down to 30. I didn't expect that. I expected to bounce at 50 back up here. But anyway, bounced back up pretty hard. I figured this was the reversal right here. I almost took it long. Because there's always two moves. Always. There's usually two moves in the morning. Either a down or an up move, and then a vice versa. So didn't take it. Tried it again here for this drop. Knew I was kind of bottom fishing a little bit, but since it didn't even pull halfway back, it only pulled like a third of the way back from this drop. So I tried it here, didn't work out. I stopped out early. I didn't want to waste any of my profit. And then drew in the wedge, and when it broke under the wedge, I shorted it down through here, profit, profit, profit. Stopped out the rest here. The market was completely sideways today. If you look at the SPY from yesterday's close through pre-market, I was like, my God, you got to be kidding me. It's almost like I'm from Florida. And when I was a kid, before they had cell phones and wave reports and stuff, and if you didn't have any buddies that were already at the beach, you'd have to go to the beach. I lived about 8 miles from the beach. You had to go to the beach, which back then was a bike ride or ride with a friend, to see what the waves were. So you get all the way there, and then it's flat. That's kind of how I felt this morning. As soon as I opened this up and it was flat, I'm like, oh man, there's no waves. I can't remember when I've seen it this flat before. Look, it's staying right in there. They don't know what the heck's going on. I mean, because of yesterday pre-market, that big drop, and it came back up just over halfway, and now it's flat. That's confusion. So when I'm trading a confused market, I take my profits quick, early, and often, and I stop out early. Like here, short it. That wasn't enough profit to take. It came up. I'm like, nope, I'm not gonna play that game. It doesn't hurt. Like I could have shorted again here, got out. Shorted again here, got out. I missed this a little bit. I should have got in right under here, but I didn't trust it. I got in under here. So then I think I tried it one more time. Yeah, that was a decent move right there for the breakdown. Okay, so this is actually, well, it's not a textbook, but it's close. This is what I call the triple play. I don't know if I've done a video on this or not, but anyway, you got the initial drop. Usually the initial drop is just like 4 or 5 bars down to the low. In this case, it took all this time here. So you got the initial drop. You got the one, two, and the third try usually breaks through and runs. I call it the triple play. Happens all the time. It's usually more defined than this. So you'll usually get an initial drop. A one, two, three. And if the one, two, or three doesn't come all the way back down to the initial drop, it doesn't count. Because a lot of times they'll drop in, come halfway back down, maybe come down a little bit more, just make their way back to the VWAP, then they'll try again. But it's the triple play. So you got the initial drop, one, two, three. Usually the one, two, and three are more separated. They're more like this. And this one dropped at 11:30. They usually drop at least by 11. Anyway, that's the triple play. Traded Intel again, although I'm not getting along with it very well. It doesn't do anything wrong, it's just I do stuff wrong. I guess for the amount it moves, it pulls back more than I think it should, and I don't like it. It didn't give me an entry to start with. Actually, it did. I shouldn't be entering here anyway. But it should have came up initially and then dropped. Anyway, shorted it here, and this is what I mean. It never follows through on anything. Pulled back. It didn't do anything wrong. Pulled back to the VWAP, and then I took profit here. I'm like, I'm not going to fool with this thing because I know what it's going to do. It's going to pull back all the way back up to my entry again, which it almost did. So Then it lured me into shorting it again too late. I should have shorted it up here. That's another thing I'm doing wrong on Intel. I got to short it closer to the tops. Just short it up here, and if I see a trade, say I just drew this in. I need to short it here and just put a stop over here. I'm shorting it too low. Shorted it here, no follow through as usual, and stopped it out even. So then I noticed it formed this nice W here, broke the trend line, and it was going to go up, but it's such a small mover, I didn't see a big upside, but actually it's just as good as my first trade, even better. I could have got 20 cents. Should have taken it long. I was thinking about taking it all through here, but I didn't do it. And I think that's all I did on Intel. Oh no, yeah. Just to piss me off, it got me again. But see, it's my fault. I took it too late. Here's another W or cup and handle right here. I was going to take it right here over to VWAP, and I didn't do it. I chased it way up here at the top for the breakout. Pops over one penny. I said, all right, it's going to go. I know it's going to go. So if it pops over again, I'm going to add a little bit more. Popped over again, one penny. I said, all right, I'm done fooling with this thing. I'm going to set my stop down here and go on to other stuff, which is what I did. Look what it did. Spiked down. Somebody spiked down and bought my stop. 10 cents away on a 20 cent mover. I don't know if that was thinkorswim or what. Look, and now it's I just can never get in on these on Intel. If it keeps it up, I may just have to take it off my list. I just can't get along with it. It's a small mover anyway, but I mean, it all depends on what share size you take. Now it's breaking down. I just can't get along with it. And to make matters worse, it was a winner. I turned it into a loser. This was a winner. This was like a 2 cent loser. And then this pop down here turned it into a loser because I added over the high. See this high right here? The high was like 11. I got in at 12 and it dropped back down. And then I think it was right in here again. I said, okay, I'm going to add a penny over that. Added at 13 and drop back down. Freaking Intel, I hate it. I had a bunch of weird stocks on my list today, stuff that I don't normally trade, but I think they were NASDAQ stocks because the NASDAQ was up. But they had good share size. I mean, this one's okay, but, and they were trading 10, 20, 40 million shares a day, and they were just skyrocketing, just like, I mean, from the last couple days. Look, this is how they all were, or better, stuff like this. So I put them on my list. I mean, they were the ones that everybody was watching. I didn't trade many of them, but I had them on my list. I've been liking to trade these energy stocks lately. Plug, and I got like 30 of them on a list. I don't know what the deal is. This one's Clean Energy Fuels. There's F-Cell and all kind of them. A lot of them are like $7, $8, $12, $18. And they're great. They don't act like penny stocks. They got millions of shares, like 20 million, 40 million, 150 million in a day. So they're nice and smooth. And you can get some good trades. I'm enjoying trading them. And I'm on my week anyway. See, this is fourth day, fifth day of trading small stocks. I quit trading. I'm not trading right now Bubba, Facebook, Apple, Tesla, all that crazy stuff, because I felt like I was gambling. Like if this was Bubba, and I say, okay, I'm going to take it over the high. I'm still undecided on that because it almost always works. I don't know. Maybe I'll just play around with them again later. But I'm trying to prove to myself I can make money, the same amount of money, and more consistently with smaller stocks. So, like, if this was Bubba and this candle pops up, that would be, like, at least 50 cents, usually a dollar or $1.50. Boom, I just close it out. And then I think to myself, well, was that luck or what? I mean, it could have popped down the same way. I mean, it could have, and they've done that before too. So I'll do that I did that for like 2 weeks straight, all green days. And then for 2 days straight, it popped over like 5 or 10 cents and then boom, tanked down. I'd have like a dollar loss or $2 loss. And then that's when I give up on them. I don't know. But you can see this is a nice move here. So I got in over here at 50, 650, let it do its thing, added right here, this consolidation. and took my profit off right here above, right at $7. And it did a 20 cent pullback, which is pretty good, decent pullback for a 50 cent move. But look, textbook right into the top of the previous resistance. Perfect. I had no idea it was going to run another 33 cents. I figured it was done because these, you know, I guess I was kind of looking at it as like a penny stock because of its price range, but it doesn't act like a penny stock. They're institutional stocks. They're energy stocks, and because of the share size they have. Okay, here's some stupidity. I mean, this is just stupid. I don't even know what I was doing. Evidently, I wasn't looking at this. It was, I don't know. I guess I wasn't paying attention to this. I don't know. Anyway, I tried to take it long here and stop me out. I did it right in the morning. I just didn't hold long enough. I got to work on my trust with these things. Again, F-cell, fuel cell energy. So I took it long here. It's a $10 stock. I could have got $1.50, but I really don't have any trust in it. But that's beside the point. All I need to do is put my stop under the 20 and let it go. Could have got a dollar. I don't know. I had no trust. No, it's a, you know, that's my thinking. $10 stock is just going to pop up and then dump off and be done for the day. Because that's what penny stocks do to me. Every time I try to trade a penny stock, especially one that's gapping up or something, look, this thing's gapping up over 50 cents. Every time I don't even put them on my charts anymore because they're a waste of chart space. They fly up right off the open, maybe 20, 40, 50 cents. Either get halted or whatever, and then they just fade off the rest of the day. Now I understand why these guys buy shorts and just fade them all day. But anyway, a decent trade if I just would have stayed in it. Anyway, I longed it here, was waiting for this, and didn't get it. It dumped off here, closed out three quarters of it even, and then a quarter of it I did leave in up to here. I don't remember if I just had my stop there or accidentally left it there or whatever, but that was the right place. I think I moved it even and wasn't paying attention to it. NCLH bled off from the start. If you remember right, I took DAL from here down, and so I missed this one. I missed it. After it started heading down, I felt like it was too extended everywhere I wanted to get in. I was like, nah, I'm not going to do that because it's going to pop back up. So, what did I do? W, wedge break, or trend break, trend line break on the W, took it long, dumps off. It was just too weak. I knew it when it started dumping off. I said, it's too weak. I shouldn't have taken that. It's just too weak. I mean, if you're going to take a W, you got to have a reasonable amount. If it were to pull back into this area and form a W, yeah. I want a pullback for my W. It's just that's just too big of a pullback. That's 23.50. 20. Oh, my God. That's over a dollar pullback on a $25 stock or a dollar downtrend. So anyway, long stopped out. Long again. I said, okay, well, maybe it just took longer to form. Maybe this is the W. Long, stopped out. I said, all right, it's too weak. Get it through your head. It's too weak. I'm going to short it here. Profit, profit, profit. And believe it or not, this is a green trade. After this is what I'm saying. It doesn't matter. If you get in and out quickly, if it doesn't work, then you're good. Losing trade, winning trade, I'm green. Short, profit, 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 profit. Winning trade. Look, I could even shorted it here. What you can do is you can just draw in these micro trend lines. I'm getting to where I don't need them anymore. I just use the 20. I can see them, you know, but I don't use them that much anymore. I just use the 20, the 9, and the 20 and get in there. Because what happened before, if I drew the trend lines, I would get in like here, and sometimes it'd be too early. It was just bouncing off the trend line and would keep going up and all that. But if I use the 20 and get in a little bit later, I'm safer. So that was those trades. Here's another example of not being right. Actually, I was right. Most of the time, it's not about being right. It's about stopping out too early. It stopped me out of the penny. Had my stop too close to the 20. Longed it here. It was a chase. I didn't want to long it, but I knew it was going to go, so I longed it anyway. This is where I wanted to get in, right here. 90. I got in 30 cents later. Hell, that would have been the trade. Should have got in here, took profit, and then waited to see what happened and got in again here. But anyway, didn't work out that way. Longed it, stopped out, longed it, took profit because I was already down, so I wanted to capture that back. And then took profit up here at 68, I think it was. So green trade, actually second biggest trade. I took bigger share size. And because it was so strong, I wanted this. I was looking at it. I'm like, no. Even though it put in a lower high, the 9 across the 20, the market just couldn't convince me because it was just just messing around. It wasn't doing anything great. And then, of course, it broke down. I didn't expect it, though, because the thing was so strong. So, green day, fourth green day in a row. I don't know, maybe more. I'm not looking at last week.